Good morning, Pirates. Welcome to the Pirate Newscast, your leading source for school news. I'm Lorelai.
And I'm Isai. Today is Tuesday, January 23rd, and here are today's top stories.
The varsity cheerleading team took home not one, but two first place titles last weekend. Last Friday, the Lakeland Senior High School, where we took first in our division and got the highlight of our senior, Rachel Chen. She was awarded a plaque for having a greater GPA than 4.0. We are so proud of her and the team. Saturday morning, the team stayed in the county and competed at the Manatee High School's first annual Canes Classic, where they earned first place. This team has overcome great obstacles this year, and through hard work, teamwork, and determination, they have reached new heights. Great job, Pirates.
Did you know that breakfast is free?
Are you kidding? I'm always so hungry in the morning, especially when I'm running late for school.
Well, next time you're hungry, make sure to stop by the cafeteria for free breakfast.
I will. Girls varsity soccer had their last regular season game last Friday against Ida Baker and won 3-0. Districts start next week. Their first game is versus Sebring at home at 6:30.
Last Friday, the boys varsity basketball team played against Parrish High School and won 49-42. Marcus Shade and Jacoby Murray combined for 25 points in the win. The boys will play tonight against Southeast.
Girls weightlifting are competing in the district championship Thursday at Port Charlotte High School. Good luck, ladies.
Track and field season officially starts on Monday, January 29th. Anyone interested in participating, please stop by Coach Minahan's room 705 for more information.
Don't forget, baseball and softball tryouts finish up today. Good luck, Pirates.
We'll be right back after these messages.
Silence and give the best of me till it's alright, but not over. I will fight like a soldier coming home in the silence. But I have never felt so free. The future's so bright. This is our time. I'm a living how it dreams.
Hello, and welcome to this important discussion about the free application for federal aid. I'm Erin Navarro, Career Pathways Coordinator for the School District of Manatee County. We're here at Braden River High School today, talking with our MAPS ambassadors, while they'll answer important questions about the FAFSA.
When can I set up my FAFSA ID?
So you can set up your FAFSA ID at any time, but it needs to be completed before the application opens, and your parents will need to set up an ID as well.
And what do I need for my FAFSA ID?
So for your FAFSA ID, you're going to need your social security number to create it.
When does the FAFSA application open?
So the FAFSA application is going to open a little later this year due to some changes, but it's going to open at December 31st at 11:59 p.m.
And why do I need to fill out the FAFSA application?
So you need to fill out the FAFSA application to be eligible for certain scholarships at colleges and universities, and you're also able to receive certain loans and grants as well.
Do I still need to fill out the FAFSA if I plan on going to MTC?
Yes, so the FAFSA applies to all technical colleges, two and four-year universities.
Do I still need to fill out the FAFSA if my parents make too much money to qualify for federal loans?
Yes, all students that plan to attend a university technical college should apply for the FAFSA so they can qualify for scholarships.
Can I still fill out the FAFSA if my parents don't have a social security number?
Yeah, so you can go see your career or college advisor at your school to get help, or you can go to a FAFSA workshop starting in January to get help as well.
We hope this discussion today has helped answer any questions that you've had on the FAFSA. If you have any additional questions, please remember, reach out to your college and career advisors as they're here to help you. Thanks for watching.
What are your New Year's resolutions?
To join more clubs.
To have better mental health.
To have better physical health.
Well, lucky for you, Youth in Action is starting the second semester. Our first meeting is January 19th.
Do the tap, dude.
We hope to see you there.
Healthy body, healthy mind.
Remember to stay drug free.
Congratulations to the Braden River FBLA chapter at the district competition. 34 students placed in the top five in 21 events and have qualified for the state competition in March. Overall, BRHS received 7 first place medals, 6 second place medals, 7 third place medals, 7 fourth place medals, 5 fifth place medals. Great job, Pirates.
Seniors, it is time for FAFSA. FAFSA, free application for federal student aid, opened on December 31st. Please take time to work on the FAFSA application. You and your parent or guardian will need an FSA ID to get started. Please see Mrs. Hedgepath if you have any questions. This is an important step as you get ready for post-graduation. Just a reminder that financial aid can be used at any type of school, MTC, SCF, or university. Do not delay. Sign up for FAFSA now.
Need time to finish an assignment? Need help on a difficult subject? Need a computer access for a class project? Join Pirate Power Hour, morning sessions Tuesday and Thursday from 7 to 7:25 a.m., room 615. Afternoon sessions are 2:30 to 3:30 p.m., Mondays, room 823.
Attention juniors and seniors interested in MTC. On February 9th, Mrs. Hedgepath will be taking a group to the MTC main campus for a tour. There is a sign-up sheet outside of her office. Don't miss this opportunity to get some good information about the amazing programs that MTC has to offer.
A reminder for seniors from Ms. Rouse. Senior fees are due. It's not too late to sign up for Grad Bash. Today, the first of the senior year will be passed out, but only if you paid your fee.
It is Literacy Week. There are some fun activities planned so you can participate and win prizes. Activities include creating a Believe in Yourself bookmark and an Adore Decorating contest. Check the Media Center webpage for more information. Hey, do you want to smile?
I would love to. What's up?
The Ag Department announces two new calves here at the river.
Oh, they're so cute. They totally just made my day. Did you know that today is Measure Your Feet Day, also National Pie Day?
Well, I like the second one better, but I'd surely enjoy Pie Day. That sounds like a good dessert.
Well, that's all for the news today. I'm Lorelai.
And I'm Issei. Remember, you can follow us on Instagram at Pirate Nation News, BRHS.
Have a great day.
Day, Pirates. Bye.